Hello, this is Dr. Fox. Let's talk about the external features of the heart. This first establishing shot is of the heart in the thoracic cavity. So we can see a right lung and a left lung. We can see the diaphragm. We can see that the wall of the thoracic cavity has been incised on each side and reflected down. We could even see the internal thoracic artery and veins, and as they bifurcate into the superior epigastric and the musculophrenic vessels. And we can see that the pericardium has been incised and reflected away. The portion of the pericardium that is reflected away is the fibrous pericardium, as well as the parietal layer of the serous pericardium, which is adhered to the deep surface of the fibrous pericardium. So this space between this layer and the visceral layer, which is upon the heart itself, is the pericardial cavity. But let's focus on that visceral layer of the serous pericardium, better known as the epicardium. The epicardium is going to take a nice shiny appearance to it. It's ciliated mesothelium, but we wouldn't be able to tell that from a gross perspective. We can see that there is copious amounts of adipose connective tissue just deep to that epicardium, more so in association with the ventricles and some of the great vessels, such as the space between the ascending aorta and the pulmonary trunk, then with the atria. So there we can see the auricle of the right atrium. Let's see, given this shot, I can't really see the auricle of the left atrium very well, but it would be approximately in this area. As we move through, I'll discuss some of the features that allow me to find my orientation when the heart is ex situ, but we can definitely start now because seeing them in situ is very helpful. So one of the major things that we look for are vessels. So there are three areas where vessels are either entering or leaving the heart. And one of the largest concentrations is along the superior, really, surface of the heart. So we've got the superior vena cava, the ascending aorta, and the pulmonary trunk, all there. Below, we would have the inferior vena cava, so we would have to look at the diaphragmatic surface for that. And then in the posterior, flanking the base of the heart, we would have the pulmonary veins returning blood into the left atrium. And as we move about the heart, we'll see these vessels and we'll be able to tell how they are as a landmark. You can also see a nice apex here, right? And let's take a look at some of the sulci and borders that are also going to allow us to orient. So there are various sulci about the heart that are indicative of deeper structures. So one of the major ones is the coronary sulcus, which I'm kind of outlining there. That coronary sulcus, also known as the atrioventricular sulcus or groove, is in line with the fibrous skeleton of the heart, which is anchoring those atrioventricular valves and the semilunar valves. And so anything below that coronary sulcus will be ventricle, and anything above is going to be atrium. In addition to the coronary sulcus, there are also two interventricular sulci, an anterior interventricular sulcus, which is approximately there. It's difficult to see with the abundance of adipose connective tissues, but when we get to the coronary arteries, we'll see this in greater detail. And so these two sulci are going to allow us to associate superficial features with chambers that are deep. So for instance, Right atrium, 100%. Right ventricle, 100%. A little bit of the left atrium. Most of the left atrium is going to be on the posterior, associated with the base of the heart. Left ventricle. And so as we begin to flesh out these borders, so for instance, here's a nice, gently convex right border. We can see how that is entirely associated with the right atrium. Or the left border here, or the obtuse margin, is largely associated with the left ventricle, but also has some left atrium in association. The superior border will have its association with both atria. The inferior border will have its association predominantly with the right ventricle, but also the left ventricle as well. And then we've got a nice apex here of the heart. That apex is pointing infero, anterior, lateral to the left. So let's continue our study of the sulci. We can see coming around here the coronary sulcus. We can also imagine that posterior interventricular sulcus there. I can see very obviously an opening for the inferior vena cava. And I can also see an opening for a pulmonary vein there. And so we're looking at the diaphragmatic surface of the heart. Here's the apex of the heart. And so this is going to be the left ventricle. This is going to be the right ventricle. In line here, obviously, this would have to be the right atrium because it's receiving the inferior vena cava. And up here, the left atrium. But again, probably not the best view of the left atrium, as we'll see. Surfaces of the heart. We have, here's more or less what I do. I take a line about the midpoint, maybe a little to the right of the midpoint, donor right, of the ascending aorta, and I draw a slightly convex line down. Then over here, I go to the left of the pulmonary trunk, again, donor's left, and I do another line sloping down, and then I connect these. And what we have then is approximately the anterior or sternocostal surface of the heart. To the right, we can see a little bit of that right surface. To the left, we can see the left or pulmonary surface. And just peeking out underneath would be the diaphragmatic surface of the heart. We can see a better diaphragmatic surface of the heart over here, that which would be resting on the diaphragm. In terms of landmarks, we've got a couple of really good ones. Here is that ascending aorta going into the arch. There is the pulmonary trunk. Here's the superior vena cava. Here, let me label these. SVC. And here are our pulmonary veins. So here is our base of the heart, diaphragmatic surface, and then this would be the left or the pulmonary surface of the heart. You can also see a little bit of the right surface of the heart there as well. So we've discussed the most superficial of layers and a little bit about orientation of the heart. We've also seen the various sulci and borders and surfaces of the heart. Thank you very much for your time.